welcome and introduce our keynote speaker. So she's a lead organizer at Tenant Work Center with Chinese Progressive Association, and this is Shazan.
Thank you, Patty and CNBC. Hello, everyone. How are you?
Thank you.
So my name is Shazan. I'm an organizer with the Chinese Progressive Association, and it's my honor to be here today speaking to the tenants of the Tenderloin and all the work that you are doing to make your community a better place. Chinese Progressive Association, who's heard of CPA? Not very many people. Okay, let me tell you a little bit about CPA. We are a grassroots community organization based in the Chinese community here in San Francisco. We organize low-wage workers, tenants, and youth around lots of different issues, you know, including worker rights, including healthcare access, healthcare justice, including education rights, and protecting good education for our children. So I'm here today to talk to you about why I believe this is our moment to build our movement. Okay, that's what I'm going to talk about today. So what's the biggest problems you're facing in your community right now in the Tenderloin?
Crime.
Okay, Zi On. Safety.
Ongoing crime.
Mm-hmm. Tinky, so sanitation cleanliness?
Open air drug use,
okay?
No access to resources.
Joblessness, 没工作室, right? Soliciting, okay?
Housing,
okay, 房屋. So that's a lot of problems. There's a lot of issues, right? And it's great that there's an organization like TNDC to bring everyone together to try to address those problems, right? So I'm going to share a little bit about some of the problems we're facing in the Chinese immigrant community in Chinatown and other neighborhoods in the city, and what we're doing to organize around them. And it's to just give it a taste of what we do, to talk about what I think why we should all do more together. Okay? So So in Chinatown and in the Chinese immigrant community, there is a lot of people who don't have jobs. Same with Tenderloin, right? There also are a lot of people who have jobs, but they don't make very much money. Anyone see that in the TL? Yeah? So, hi, why is it? For example, we have examples of workers who work in a restaurant, and a Vietnamese restaurant out in the Richmond district, okay? They were making $60 a day, working 10-hour days. We had examples of workers who take care of elderly, right? Caregivers, who were told by their patient, if you don't let me touch you where I want to touch you, I won't pay you, okay? So, we have examples of another restaurant worker who didn't get paid anything for 6 months' time. working for free for 6 months time, okay? 还有一个仓库工人工作，我可以一分钱都没出粮, okay? So these examples are pretty bad, right? I mean, what is it like to work in a job like that? Not good, right? It's not good for our community, right? It means people are less secure, right? It leads to more crime when people don't make enough money to make ends meet, right? People are working like that, they don't have time to take care and be part of their neighborhoods, right? So 如果是这样，有没有工作情况会令到乜嘢？我哋嘅社区会更加唔安全，系咪？因为人哋搵唔到工作，或者冇好工资，咁佢哋冇时间，可能会犯罪，或者会有其他方式搵生活方法，系咪？同埋佢哋冇时间参加嗰啲社区活动，right? But these three examples I just gave you, they're not fictional. They're not made up. They're real examples. And all three of those examples, those workers decided to speak up, even though they were very afraid to lose their jobs, very afraid to not be able to take care of their families, very afraid of the bosses being mad at them. They decided to stand up and get together with their coworkers and fight back. And each one of those cases, those workers are winning or have won already, okay? So, 那三個例子都不是假的，它們是真實的例子。那每一個例子，那些工人，他們雖然很害怕，很害怕失去一份工作，他們決定想站起來爭取權益，組織跟其他工友一起組織爭取權益。 同埋佢哋都勝利咗, okay? So in the Vietnamese restaurant example in the Richmond, it was in the papers, eight workers recovered over $316,000 in back wages because they sort of fought together, okay? So 如果你等下，我们都有还有奖报纸，系咪？嗰啲工人因为佢哋组织工友一齐争取，八位工人佢哋争取翻三十一万蚊多工资，okay? So